Hey guys, my name is Jordy from the YouTube channel CineCam, and this is not a usual episode. We have actually partnered up with LG Ultrawide, and together with a bunch of other creators, we are making an educational series called LG Ultrawide Class. Now we are kicking it off as the first contributor with this tutorial video on how to recreate 4 transitions from the Sherlock Holmes series in Adobe Premiere Pro. Now, there is a link in the description below to the LG Ultrawide YouTube channel, and if you subscribed to them, you will see the next tutorials coming from other creators to you very soon. The series Sherlock Holmes is famous for its amazing visual storytelling. Definitely, their transitions are often quite simple yet amazing. In the first transition, we see Sherlock sitting in the car. The right side fades away, and then also the left side. So we've recreated that. Here we have a shot of Lorenzo cracking the next case in his car, and also a shot through the window which represents his view. We're going to dive into Adobe Premiere Pro, where Jannik is going to show you guys how to recreate that transition. You want to start off by placing the shot of the car on the bottom of your timeline. On the point where you'd like the transition to start, you add the second shot on top of that clip. We're going to draw a mask on this clip that goes right next to the chassis of the car. So we want to see the layer below, and that's why I'm going to disable the output of the second layer. But I keep that clip in there selected. Then you head over to your effects controls, and under the opacity, click on the pen tool. This allows you to draw a mask around the chassis of the car. And once you're done, you can enable video track number 2 again to reveal what you've just created. Under the mask properties, you might want to feather it a little bit. And if your shot wasn't perfectly still, we'll have to animate the mask with the movement of the car. To do that, enable the mask path animation. And now you can move forward in time and adjust your mask where needed. Finally, go back to the opacity and change its value to 0 in the beginning of the clip, then go a little bit forward in time and change it back to 100. And this already gives you the first half of the transition. The second half is super simple. What you want to do is select the upper clip, hold down the Alt key, and drag it to the track above to make a duplication of it. Now, this also duplicated the effects and everything with it, so we're going to remove the mask from it and reset the opacity back to a fixed 100. Then just trim the clip a little bit and add a cross-dissolve transition to the beginning of the clip, and that's it. Now, many of the transitions in Sherlock Holmes are created using masks, so a lot of the stuff that we've just seen will come back. The next one is where Sherlock bends over to a car window. Now, he goes from an interior shot to an outside shot, and this is created by first filming your actor bending over in the first scene. And you can already place this shot on the first track in your timeline. Then have a second shot of the same movement with an actual car in the foreground, and place this in the track above. And what you want to do now is match the position of the two clips. The easiest way to do this is by decreasing the opacity of the clip on top. You can now see through it, which will help you to reposition and scale it using the motion properties. You can also nudge the clip forward or backwards by holding down the Alt key on your keyboard and then just using the left or right arrows. And try to really match the two clips so that it seems like one fluent movement. And once that is done, set the opacity back to 100 and take the pen tool again to draw a mask around the hood of the car. Enable animation and move your mask over time. If everything went well, the transition should already work, but we're going to fine-tune it a little bit more. And since it are two different scenes, you can give two different color gradings to it as well using Lumetri. But I'm actually going to start with the first one and copy its Lumetri effect to the second clip. They will now have the same color tone, which is good for when the hood of the car starts to reveal itself. From the Lumetri effect on the second clip, I'm going to enable the animation for all the properties that I want to change. If you're not sure which one, you can enable all of them. Then move a little bit further in time and change your Lumetri settings to the color grading that you would like to see in your second scene. And now the transition is much more fluent and natural. Next up is the pass-by transition. You take a panning or a sliding shot of your subject with some kind of a foreground to have a better sense of the movements. I'm going to actually shoot this against a dark background. So in my second shot, I'm making sure that there's also a dark foreground object. Here I just had a black jacket laying over the red fridge. Make sure that both of the movements are somehow at the same speed. In Premiere Pro, you place the first shot on the second track and the second shot on the first track like this. We'll then draw a rough mask on the upper clip in the dark area. Make sure to feather the mask a bunch as well. Then, like before, animate the mask path to reveal the clip below. And once that is done, you might want to nudge the clips a little bit to get them into the right spot. And as a final touch, you could also use Lumetri to have the dark areas match in deepness and color tone. And that brings us to the last transition, which is for once not a mask. We have one shot of an open door, but I also pay attention to the left side of the shot and make sure that there is a straight vertical line. Then we take another shot of a door opening, and it's important now that the side of the door matches with the position of the window from your first shot. In Premiere Pro, the first clip goes on top, and below that, the second shot. Like before, I decrease the opacity of the layer on top so that it can match the scale and position with the one below. Reset your opacity back, and what I'm gonna do now is duplicate the top clip. On that duplication, it will add the crop effect. And with the effect selected, you can now visually move the right side to where you want the door to open. Then you copy the value of the right property, add the crop effect to the second layer, which is the same clip, and then paste the value in the left side attribute. Now select your upper layer again and animate the right property to follow the door as it opens up. And just like we've seen previously, you can duplicate the bottom layer to the top, trim it, and add a cross dissolve to let it fade completely into the next shot. And those were the four iconic transitions from the Sherlock Holmes series. Now, as part of the LG Ultrawide class, I'm going to leave you with a short life experience as a YouTube creator. Now, I used to focus a lot on the numbers and the keywords that I should use to grow my audience. But I've stopped doing that, as it was not only exhausting me, but also it didn't have much effect. So when I gave up on that, I started to focus solely on the creative process. I would only create things that I would love to work on, videos or topics that come straight out of my heart. And even without realizing it, our channel was blowing up. And I believe that goes for anything that you as a creative person creates. In the first place, always do it from the heart and focus on the production of your film project rather than on the outcome. Now, thank you so much for watching. Thank you, LG, for letting me be part of this educational series. And I look very much forward to what follows next. And if you do too, then make sure to check out their channel as well. And as always, remember, stay creative.